I am Liana, better known as Queen. I'm 23 years old, 5'5", 250 pounds, and I'm from LA, baby. Los Angeles, California. Don't trip.
Monday, and as you guys may know, a lot of people that work at a church, they get Mondays off. However, I don't get Mondays off. Because on Mondays, I'm on. I'm doing school. I'm a grad student. So right now, I'm just working on a couple assignments, some papers, but I'm hungry. So I'm going to take me a lunch break, and I'm about to roll into Chipotle and give me one of my favorite meals. So as soon as I come back out of there, I'm going to show y'all what I like to eat from Chipotle. So I'll be right back.
Ooh,
that line was long. I'm telling y'all, Chipotle is the business. Okay, well, let me tell you what I got from Chipotle. I like to get what's called a burrito bowl, which is basically whatever you can get inside a burrito, but no tortilla. I like to do mine nacho style. When you go to Chipotle, get a veggie bowl, because with the veggie bowls, the guacamole, it comes free. And I'm telling y'all, guacamole is not cheap, especially when you're a struggling college student. So you take all those ingredients, you mix that bad boy up, you get you some chips, you dip it in there like it's the best nachos you ever had. This is my job. This is where I work, Faithful Central Bible Church. This is our receptionist, Charlotte. Good morning, Charlotte.
Yeah.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
And we're just walking down the hall. This is the pathway to my office. And I'm going to introduce you to my boss. Good morning, Pastor Monique. We typically say hola. Hola, Pastor Monique. Say bye to the camera. Okay, and this is my office here right here. It's a little junky, but acting like it's real life, and it is. So there's my desk and, you know, the nice, beautiful wall.
Something that you would not know just from looking at me. I love to preach. It is what fuels me. It's like nothing gives me passion and just... Nothing gives me passion like standing behind a pulpit and delivering truth. Truth that heals people. Truth that sets
my biggest workout.
Because I walk off that stage sweating.
So though sometimes you may not experience God like you want to experience Him, He's saying, I still love you. I've still extended grace to you. I still woke you up this morning with brand new mercies. I still put food onto your table. I still provide for you when you feel like there's no way. Example for me. My parents didn't have money to pay for me to go through college, you know? And I'm just like, well, God, how can a girl like me, who come from a low-income family, who doesn't have the money to pay to go to a private school like Bio that costs thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars a year? Not the entire, you won't believe how much my school costs, but it's only me stepping back and saying, God, I can't see it, I can't touch it, I can't hear it, I can't feel it, but I will trust
it. Let me fool you. Quickly, I don't know how to get down.
Tradition that every Easter we get together and we have some type of food celebration and just remembrance. And this Easter, we're doing a family barbecue. I'm going to bring the barbecue baked beans. It's a family tradition that we have baked beans next to our barbecue. And so I'm just going to show you a little bit of how we make baked beans in my house or in my family. First of all, you get you a pound of pork bacon. This is not necessarily the most healthy way to make baked beans. But you leave in the skillet, or you put back from the other batches, the grease, the fat from the bacon. Yum, I know. Vegetables, you got a little vegetables, you take some bell pepper and onion, and you cook that in the actual bacon fat. So, you know, you have some seasoned bell pepper and onion. You take bell pepper and onion, you put that in the skillet here, as I'm doing. While the bell pepper and onion is cooking, you take the bacon and you begin to crumble it up in the pork and beans. You see some pork and beans, so you get canned pork and beans. It's not the most sanitary, no gloves. You go all authentic, this is back home style. You put some bacon in here, as I'm doing. When the bacon is done, when I'm finished crumbling the bacon in here, and the bell pepper and onion is done cooking, I'm gonna take the bell pepper and onion, throw it in here. You put a little mustard, some brown sugar, a little bit of barbecue sauce. We don't do measurements, you just judge. You mix that bad boy up, you stick it in the oven for about 45 minutes, you take it out, you have the best baked beans on this side of heaven. Easter celebration. This is my aunt whose house the barbecue is at. They say she's my twin. This is my uncle. Say hi, Uncle Evan.
Hey, Uncle Evan.
Say hi, Uncle Evan. My grandpa. So we about to have a party. You know, check me out later. I'll show you a little bit of my taboo skills and some of my competitive nature. Come on.
When it's like, I don't know that.
Come on, come on, Anti. 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 Yeah. Anti. Yeah. Anti. I said memories. That's all that counts.
Can you guys?
Remember, I've always been the big girl in my family, the big girl in my group of friends, and it was not until around October of 2007 that my life had changed. I was in college, and I remember just being very depressed. It was a week where I just didn't get out of my bed or anything. However, a special day happened in October of 2007. My church had a special prayer service. And I remember being right here at this altar on my knees and kind of just sick and tired of my situation, sick and tired of my depression, sick and tired of battling with my insecurities and my fears. And I remember sitting at this altar and I prayed and I cried and I prayed and I cried. And the song in the background that was playing was a song called Yes. And the words just kept repeating yes. And in that moment, I made a declaration that I would surrender myself to the process of losing weight. It went into 2008, and 2008 was the best year of my life. During that year, I lost just about 100 pounds. However, 2009 was the worst year of my life. I battled with up 2 pounds, down 2 pounds, and over 2009, I have struggled to lose an inch of weight, and that is why I'm applying for this show, because I feel stuck. I feel helpless. I feel like I've come so far, yet I have so far to go, and the thought of that is fearful, it's paralyzing, and I don't know what to do. I feel like I need a second wind, and I don't have it, and I don't know where to get it from, and I'm just ready to just move on with my life and to get the rest of this weight off of me. So I'm begging you to help me. I'm just gonna show you a little bit about just my body and my daily routine back at home with some things that I struggle with when it comes to my weight. One thing I just hate about being overweight is that I don't feel feminine. Every single morning in my life, I have to wake up and I have to shave my face because being overweight has caused a lot of hair to grow on my body. I even have to take pills prescribed by the doctor to fight against my hair growth, but it doesn't work. And so I never feel attractive, I never feel pretty, and I often get depressed about my condition. And I'm just sick and tired of feeling like a guy. I want to feel like a girl sometimes. What girl wakes up and shaves her face before she leaves the house? Not only do I have to shave my face in the morning, but every couple weeks, my dad has to shave my back just so that I can wear shirts that, not only do I have to shave my face in the morning, but every couple weeks, my dad has to shave my back. And it took me a really long time to even get comfortable with asking him to do that because it's just very embarrassing, but it's the only way I can wear girly shirts and feel like the rest of the women at the parties that I go to. So, Dad, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Go for it. over a year ago and I still can't fit them. I can barely pull them up. I can't zip them. I can't bun them. I'm sick of being fat. I'm sick of... I want to cry, but I can't even cry no more. I've cried enough. I'm angry. Like, Kaya gave me this dress last spring so that I could wear this last summer. Here we are, 2010, the summer is approaching, and look at my stomach. I can smell the clothes. I want to feel pretty in the clothes I wear. There's no way I can feel pretty in this. I can't do this by myself. I'm tired. I'm tired of getting up and going to the gym and trying to eat right, and I can't even fit the dresses that I want to look pretty in for the summer. Sometimes I try to be encouraged by the fact that I lost 100 pounds, but this is what I see when I look up, when I get up in the morning. This is what I see when I look in the mirror. I feel fat. I am fat. And I tell people, oh, I'm going on the Biggest Loser. They tell me, Liana, you're not big enough. I'm not big enough. Do you see how much I weigh? This, I get on this scale every morning. And does it change? No. Liana weighs 250 pounds. I'm not big enough. I'm sick of being the biggest in my group of friends. I'm sick of being the fattest person in my family. I am 23 years old, 5'5", and weigh 250 pounds? Are you kidding me? I'm not big enough. I gotta lose a whole nother person. This is my friend, Lanice. Tell the people at The Biggest Loser how much you weigh.
I weigh 115 pounds.
115 pounds, and this is her normal size. She didn't do anything extravagant. Can you imagine that I want to lose a Lanice and some, and people have the audacity to tell me I'm not big enough for the show? I'm not the best candidate for the show, but I'm the most unique candidate for the show. I've already proven to you that this matters to me. I've already proven to you that I'm dedicated to this journey. However, I feel stuck. I feel hopeless right now, and so I need your help to continue on. But don't get it twisted. The weight loss is not the only reason. I'm in it to win it, because I owe Sally Mae a buttload of money from college loans. So let's go.
She's determined, she's diligent. She
doesn't back down.
Ambitious, she is creative.
Vibrant and full of life and
likes to have fun in everything that she does. She laughs at anything.
Brings a smile to my face every single time I see her.
Confident and excellent.
A great personality, a really personal person.
Devoted, loyal.
Passionate and powerful.
Irreplaceable.
Faithful, committed.
Determined to be America's next biggest loser.
Make it, she is all of that in a bag of chips. You understand? Well, maybe I should say a bag of carrots. She's a winner. She's a fighter. She does like carrots. As a matter of fact, she was sitting there eating a power bar. Come on. She's getting prepared to be on the doggone show. Tell you something, I would love to click on the TV and see her running up a mountain as I'm eating my chips and my hot dogs.
Liana is just ready to live her best life. Oftentimes people ask me, Liana, what do you want to look like? Or, you know, what body type do you want to have? And honestly, I tell them there's no person that I look to that I want to be like. I want to be the me inside of me. Often I feel trapped inside of me, and that's the only person I desire to be.